This is workload example 5.5. This problem, the data given is something like this. A line AB of 65 mm long. So that means true length of the line is 65. According to our notation, A dash B1 dash, that is equal to AB1, that is equal to A dash B2 dash, that is equal to AB3 equal to 65. Mm. And end A of the line is 20 mm above HP. So first I will take the XY line. End A is 20 mm above HP. That means 20 mm above at 20 distance. I will draw one locus line. This is locus of A dash. End A is 20 mm above HP. 20 mm above HP means we will get the front view of that point. 20 mm above the XY line. And the same point A is 25 mm in front of VP. A point is some distance in front of VP means we will get the top view below the XY line. That means at distance of 25 mm from the XY line, I will get the top view of the point. That means this is the locus of A. The end B is 40 mm above HP. So end B is 40 mm above HP means at a distance of 40, I will draw one more locus line. This is the 40 distance. And this is locus of B dash. And the point B is 65 mm in front of VP. A point is 65 mm in front of VP means after rotation the top view will come 65 mm below the XY line. So below XY at a distance of 65, I will draw the locus of A. So the locus of B. This is the locus of B. Draw the projections of line AB and find out the inclinations. That means theta comma phi you have to find. So to solve this problem, somewhere randomly I will take the A dash point. Okay, then by drawing the projector automatically I will get point A in the top view. True length is given, so very easily I can complete the simple position. That means at a distance of 65 you mark B1 dash, this line length is 65. Then if you draw a projector, you will get B1. This is the initial top view and front view. That means simple position of the line is completed. Now, if you rotate the line something like this, then observe what is the point you are getting in the standard problem. If you rotate this B1 dash line, you are going to get B2 dash. Instead of giving this theta, now this distance is given. This line locus is given. Now by rotating B1 dash you will get B2 dash. So rotate this B1 dash until it intersects with this locus line. Now the point you are going to get here is B2 dash. Now A dash B2 dash is the again true length, and this angle is the true inclination theta. If you draw a projector from B2 dash to the initial front view, you will get the initial top view AB1, you will get the reduced top view, that is AB2. Now again observe the standard problem. If you rotate this AB1 something like this until it intersects with this locus line, you are going to get B3. Now you rotate it something like this until it intersects with this locus line, then automatically you will get B3. B3 you will get somewhere here. Now AB3 is again representing the true length, that is 65, and this angle will be the phi. Now from B3 you draw a projector to the initial front view, that is A dash B1 dash, then automatically you will get the reduced front view A dash B3 dash. after obtaining the reduced front view a dash b3 dash and a reduced front view and reduced top view, that is ab2, to get the final projections you just take the reduced front view a dash b3 dash and rotate it until it touches the locus of front views, that is locus of b dash or locus of front view. Now a dash is center, a dash b3 dash is radius, you rotate it something like this, draw an arc, then you will get b dash. A dash b dash is the final front view, this angle is alpha apparent angle. Now you take this reduced top view and rotate it something like this until it touches this locus line AB. Then this is the final top view, this angle is apparent angle beta. The verification is B dash and B must lie on the same projector.